switch it on over and we're gonna get started for today. Just the hair. Make sure my framing is all good. I'd become a videographer with all this stuff. Okay. All right, guys. Let me have you standing up first. And we'll start in with it. Oh, I'm a little fuzzy. Hold on just a second. Let me refocus. There we go. Okay. All right, standing up first. We're going to start nice wide stance to get things going for today. So here, hand center. I want you to take a nice big deep breath in. Reach up. Push those hips forward. And then breathe it out. Hinge over. Just reach to the floor right in front of you. And nice and easy into it. You don't have to go super deep right away. Exhale, breathe out, reach towards the floor. Down, and I want you to reach back and through behind you. Palms flat on the floor. I'm just going to sit there for a little bit. Get into some scooping hamstring stretches. We're going to do probably a few second hold on each one. So I want you to plant your left foot first. You're going to take your right leg, straighten it out. heel down, toe up. Left knee slightly bent, chest out nice and tall. From here, we're gonna hinge over, reach down. I want you to reach with that left hand, try to touch that right foot. Reaching with that right hand down towards that left foot. Left leg nice and straight. We're gonna shift back over into that wide stance. And we're gonna be dropping down into this Cossack squat. Now, when we drop into this Cossack squat, if you wanna put your hands down on the ground to give you some extra support, by all means, go ahead. We are going to be rotating and turning the straight leg foot up to the ceiling. So we're really gonna try to pull into that side position. So what this will look like, we're gonna shift over to the left side first. So you're gonna drop your left hip. Put your hands down to the inside on the floor, that's fine. Then I want you to take this right foot and turn it up. Okay. Now, if you need to put a hand behind you, that is okay. I want you to just have that right foot toe up. Okay, holding, supporting right here. If you don't need hands, you don't have to have hands. You can just sit into here. And as you do this, try to let your hips sink down as much as you can. You should feel a good pull through this right leg, through the inside of that right leg. Again, you can use your hands to support yourself and just pull into that stretch. Trying to heat this adductor, this medial hamstring, this inside hamstring here. Out of the stretch, you're going to lock your hands over and we'll shift over to the other side. So again, you can have both hands down, Try to keep this side foot flat, and then use straight leg, that left leg, toe up, heel down. Really try to sit the hips back. So again, if you need your hands, hands down behind you, one in front, whatever support you need. Try to let the hips sink down towards the mat. And then same thing, use the hands, ease yourself out, walk it over, and drop that hip down, toe up. Holding right here. Again, take your time getting to the stretch. And remember that straight leg, we're having toe up to the ceiling. Out, and we're going to go right into our deep lunge position with the left leg forward. So you're going to walk your hands up. We're going to be to the inside of your left leg, right leg, nice and straight back. The right knee down to the mat, lay that right foot flat. We're going to try and sink this right elbow down to the floor, and I want you to take that left hand and reach up to the ceiling, drop your left knee out as much as you can. Open up the shoulders, open up, reach back behind you with that left hand as much as you can. right there. And then from here, I want you to turn and lay onto that right hip, and you're going to push yourself up with your right hand. So we're going to be in this kind of big extended position, trying to work some external rotation with this left hip. So again, you're going to lay onto your right side. You might have to bring this left foot back just a little bit. And we're trying to push this left knee out here, prop yourself up with your right arm. I just turned around so you could see me. Take back. So hands back down on the floor. Walk that left foot forward just a little bit if you had to scoot it back. And you're going to drop your hips forward, arms straight. Now from here, with your left hand, plant that right hand. You're going to take your left hand, reach around, bring that right leg up, and grab a hold of your foot. Drop again, a little bit down to that right side. Pull your heel towards your butt. Again, this is going to be a tough one. If you have a strap or a belt of some sort, you can take the strap, loop it around your foot. Of that lunge, and then we're going to switch over to the other side. So we're going to be right leg forward, left leg back, back leg nice and straight. So straighten out that back leg first, just holding this deep lunge position. Drop the knee, flatten that back foot out. Try to push the hips forward. Nice straight arms. Okay, from this position, we're going to drop onto the left elbow, and we're going to extend that right arm up to the ceiling, reach and try to open up as much as you can. Only double-jointed hip flexor that we have passes through two joints. Back onto the knees. Pulling the sock off. Okay. We're going to stretch into the bottom of the feet. For those of you that have been doing a lot of running, or even just some of the plyos you've been doing in the live workouts, I want you to pull your toes up underneath you and really sit back, squeeze. I've been liking to include this one pretty much every week. Just to help keep that plantar fascia stretched out and loose. If you guys start feeling a little bit of like stabbing pain in the bottom of your foot, you've been doing a lot of running or some plyos, it's a great one to do pretty much every day. And it's really easy to do. All you gotta do is sit on your toes. Try to keep your heels close together. They don't have to be like knocked together, but a little bit of gap is fine. And you just sit back and try to get your toes to flex as much as you can. Feel like you need a little bit more stretch as you lean back more, the more you need to squeeze your glutes as you do this. reverse it. So you're going to point your toes, lay your feet flat, bring the heels close together, and same deal, just sitting down on the top of the feet. Flexing that big toe as much as you can. So you bring your heels in, it lines up all those tissues and muscles up underneath so that we get into the arch and those big toe muscles, those big toe flexors. Stretch those out. Nice and slow, come on up. And last stays to sit here, laying your feet flat. And sit on the come up onto the knees. I want you to have your knees a little bit wider apart so you have just a good base here. And we're going to work on just opening up some upper mid back. So you're going to have hands down, open this quadruped position. I want you to take your right hand, you're going to put it just behind your right ear. From here, we're going to drop that elbow over to the left arm. Nice and slow, I want you to push your left hand, reach that elbow up to the ceiling, rotate up. Good. Nice and slow, bring it down. And coming up. Two more. from there, we're going to take the right arm, and you're going to reach through and across and drop that right shoulder down to the ground. Try to reach through as much as you can. Nice and easy, come on up. We're going to take that right hand. You'll put it out, over, and on top of the left. And I want you to sit the hips back, trying to get a good pull through the lat, through the backside of that right shoulder. If you're not feeling too much, move it off to the left a bit more. Sitting back and reach. It's going to be in that half kneeling position, left knee down. We're going to have both arms straight out in front. From here, you're going to pull back with that right shoulder blade, rotate open, reach back with that right arm. Shoulder blade back, push that left arm forward, rotate, and open. Now, as you're doing this one, I want you to try to focus on squeezing this left glute, so the down leg, that side glute. Good, bring it on back, back up front, and one more time. Pull that right shoulder blade back, extend that left arm out, rotate and reach, squeeze that left glute. Now, last position of this series, you're going to take your right hand, drop it down towards that left down foot, trying to touch your heel. Reach up with the left hand, and then same deal. I really want you to squeeze that left glute. Now try not to arch your back. Think about rotating and then reaching. Squeeze that left glute as much as you can. bring the right leg back. We're gonna bring that left hand. We're gonna work on the left side. So we're gonna do left hand just behind the ears. From there, you're gonna drop your left elbow down towards your right arm. And then push through that right arm, rotate up and reach. Reach up with that left elbow. Back and rotate up, reach. Two more. Rotate up, reach, push through that right arm, extend that right arm as much as you can. And bring it back down. And last one, rotate, push, reach. And easy, bring it on down. From here, we're going to take the left arm and you're going to reach through and underneath the right as much as you can. Drop that left shoulder down to the ground. Just a little bit, take the left hand, put it on top, rear flatten the feet, sit on back, trying to get a good pull through that left shoulder, through the back of that left shoulder. Okay. We are going to bring that left knee up. Right leg is going to be down in that half kneeling position. From here, you're going to have both arms straight out in front. And we're going to do the same thing, but we're going to be rotating out towards the left side. So you're going to push that right arm forward, left shoulder blade back. Open up, reach. Shoulder blade back, reach forward with the right arm, and open. Shoulder blade back, rotate open and reach. Okay, from this open position, last one, you're going to drop your left hand down towards that right heel, reach your right arm up, squeeze your left butt cheek as you do it. Position we're going to drop into. We're going to take this left leg, we're going to take the left foreleg, we're going to bring it on across. We're going to be down into our pigeon stretch. So we're going to start arms straight, chest nice and high. I want you to focus on reaching back with that back foot first. Now, I was saying that during cardio, I don't know about you guys, but yesterday's live session, that lower body workout, I am sore. So again, chest tall. Now if you need a little more leverage with this pigeon stretch, you can take your right hand and put it on top of that left foot, and that'll help just pull a little more leverage into the hip, keeping the left knee down, and then try to drive that right hip, rotate it down towards the floor. That'll put even more pull through the left. Drop down onto the elbows, and we're going to sit here for a good minute. As you sit here, I want you to remember to breathe. Breathe through it. Close your eyes. Try to sink just a bit deeper with each breath. Into that hip. With each breath, just try to let those muscle fibers relax and fall apart. to that left hip and just have a seat. You're going to bring your right knee slightly out in front. Pull your right heel to your butt, and you're going to straighten out that left leg. You're going to take your right hand, and we're going to reach forward and across to that left foot. Foot tucked. I want you to lean back, squeeze your right glute, get a good pull into that right quad. Foreleg over in front. We're going to reach that left leg back, transferring to that pigeon stretch. The right leg up front this time. Left leg back, try to reach back as much as you can. Again, if you need some more leverage, put your left hand on your left foot, your right hand on your left. Now, as we do this pigeon stretch, you're not sitting back onto this right hip. Don't do this. You should be up. You should be trying to drive that left hip down towards the ground. This one, you can flip over onto your back and do that figure four. There you go. Okay, we're gonna come on over to that right hip. You're gonna take your left knee, tuck it back, or sorry, left foot, tuck it back up underneath you. We're gonna straighten out that right leg. Take your left hand and reach out towards your right foot. Foot pulled back up underneath the hip, and I want you to squeeze this left glute as you sit back. A good pull through that left forward, relax. Oh. Whew. Okay, guys. That'll do it for today. Now we had some nice little series there. Oh, opened up the shoulders and the back a little bit. Yeah. Well, oh, that does it for Bendability today. I hope you enjoyed yourselves. I will catch you guys next week. Do remember, too, we are adding on a 7:30 a.m. Time slot for our live classes, too. So if you want to get it done early in the morning, you can. And, yeah, I'll send out that info with this Bendability video for you guys.